Reagan, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome and thank you for watching, and don't forget to go ahead and hit that subscribe button and notification bell so you'll be notified when I post videos. If you're a returning subscriber, welcome back and thank you for always supporting my channel. So today, y'all be loving when I do foundation reviews. So today I'm coming at y'all with another foundation review. And I'm sure, like, y'all know, if y'all been watching my channel, y'all already know that I tried the Il Makiage foundation. And I took that little color match quiz and all that. And it was not, the foundation itself was not bad. But the color match quiz sucks. So if you're going to order that, pick your own color based off the pictures or what you know of your skin. But don't trust the quiz match. So when I saw Mintic Cosmetics, they were doing a quiz match and it was like, oh, for women of color or whatever. And you know, I'm light skinned, still a woman of color. So I was like, okay, let me try this because I've been looking for a foundation that really, really, really matches my skin. So I went ahead and did their quiz match and they sent me a color. And I was like, okay, it was $45. So I ordered it. You know, this one you have to pay full price. They're not doing the whole free thing, and then if you don't like it, return it, like Il Makiage was doing. But it was cool because of the reviews and stuff I saw, all of them seemed like positive, so I didn't really mind honestly spending the $45. Well, no, I don't think the foundation was $45, I don't know, but I'll link it down below. I ended up buying their foundation and where's the brush, and I bought their foundation brush to apply it, which is right here. And you see it has minted on it. I don't know if it's gonna focus, but it says minted. The same, and this is their logo for Mintic Cosmetics. It looks just like this. And so after I did my quiz match, they matched me with the color L30. So my understanding that they have like a light, medium, dark. I will say if you are a lighter skinned woman like me, this foundation to me is geared towards darker skinned women, which is nothing wrong for that, wrong with that, because I know a lot of times for them versus us, it's a lot of makeup brands out there that include our shade but not theirs. So the lightest shade that Mintic Cosmetics has is, I believe, an L10. So it goes L10, L20, L30. They gave me an L30, which I still feel like it could be a little dark, but you know, summertime's coming and I need that summertime foundation color. So, but what I'm gonna do is go ahead and do my eyebrows, and then I'm gonna come back and let y'all watch me put on the foundation and just tell y'all, you know, what I think of it, all that kind of stuff. If you want to know my skin type, my skin is dry, super dry. It is not combination, it's not oily, it's super, super dry. I prefer a dewy foundation look. Definitely always look for something that's moisturizing, and you know, can give my skin that extra glow that it needs by me already having dry skin. But I've already kind of prepped my face. After I do my eyebrows, I'll come back on and put on my primer and we'll get into the foundation. I filled in my eyelashes with my Anastasia Beverly Hills. My eyebrows with my Anastasia Beverly Hills. So now I am about to get into the makeup. So my main thing I like to do is I like a flawless but natural makeup finish. As you can see, I have some freckles here I'm trying to cover. My T-zone, as you can see, is so dry. That's mostly where I get dry at, is right in my T-zone, which I hate. So I'm gonna take some of my Too Faced Hangover Primer. And I'm gonna go ahead and put it on my face. And yeah, if y'all want this shirt I have on is from Fashion Nova. Just in case anybody asks, I'll link it down below in the comments if it's still even on that website. Okay, so now, like I said, I ordered this from Mintic Cosmetics. This is not sponsored. I ordered this on my own money. And like I said, I did the little quiz match they have, the questions they ask. And as you can see, I'm in the color L30. And this is made in the USA, had the shelf life of 18 months. And this brand is cruelty free and vegan. As a lot of y'all know, I am vegan, so that's definitely something that's very important to me when I'm looking for makeup, because a lot of the makeups we put on our skin are not good for us. So when I open it up, this is the color that it is. It's a foundation stick, and this is the second foundation stick I've ever tried. The only other one I had was the Anastasia Beverly Hills foundation stick, and that one did really good on my skin. So as you can see, this looks a little caramel compared to my skin, but like I said, if you are my shade or lighter, they do have two shades lighter than this. And if you are a darker skin or caramel skin, brown skin woman, you have a plethora of other shades to choose from on the back end. So alright, so I'm going to go ahead and start applying the foundation. As y'all can see, I probably could have done an L20. But by the time I set it, it should be good. And whenever I say my foundation color is off, y'all always going to be in the comments like, girl, you look fine. It's not off. Okay, this is the foundation brush they have on their site, so I kind of just wanted to get the brush so I could use their brush for putting the foundation out. But you see it's really like, it feels so good. You see, it's like melting into my skin, like it looks really good. And it looks thick, but it doesn't feel thick or like cakey or anything at all. It feels really, really good on my skin. But like, it doesn't even feel like I'm putting anything on. Like, you know, certain brands, as soon as you like put them on, it's like they start to feel cakey. It definitely doesn't feel like that. And this color looks really good. I wanna say they match me right, y'all. I thought it was gonna be too dark, but it wasn't. I don't think it is. I think it's good. Because you never want to be that girl that your face is one color and your neck is another. Nobody wants to be her. Nobody. Nobody, sis. Nobody. Okay. If y'all hear anybody crying in the back, that is my daughter. I do have a 5-month-old and she's not going to be quiet for this video. So yeah, I love this, y'all. This is so, like, it feels so nice and creamy on my skin. I'm gonna have to do like a wear test, like a 12 hour wear test on this. Cause y'all know we ain't been going nowhere cause of quarantine, but like, look at this. Like, hold on. Let me get it close so y'all can see. Look at that. Like, look at how flawless that looks. Oh my gosh. I love it. And you can still see like my mole. I never want to cover that up anyway because it's like my beauty mole, but I might put a little more on the side. It's definitely, I would call this full coverage, to be honest, unless you're one of them people that like to slather your face and like, you know, make everything. But it's definitely like, as you can see, the coverage is buildable. So if that's not dark enough for you, and I'm gonna definitely get under my eyes again, because like I said, I got a brand new baby and I don't get no sleep. So like, and then like, I don't know if it's because I'm using their brush, but I think their brush was only $10, which is why I got it, because the normal foundation brush I use is this plain Wet n Wild brush, but it's like dirty. Even though I've cleaned it, it's like stained, so I need a new one anyway, or either I use a beauty blender. But yeah, I love this, y'all. This might be like my new go-to foundation, definitely if I want something like cool and like just an everyday, no special occasion look that's good on my skin, not all those toxic heavy metals and all that other crazy stuff, like boom. So now I'm going to just put on some concealer, and they have other foundation sticks that I guess I could order in a lighter color if I wanted to conceal and contour with them. I know they also have a setting powder, so it's definitely something that I would probably like. This foundation kind of reminds me a little bit of Bare Minerals, just the lightness of it all. But yeah, it's definitely worth the money. It's definitely, you should take the quiz and let them match you, because they definitely did a good job, I feel like. Like a super good job. They did a super, super good job matching me. Just kind of, I mean, highlighting a little bit under my eyes. And I'm gonna set my face. Like I said, I did not. But like, that just looks so flawless. Like, look at my face. It looks so good. Yeah, that looks so. That looks so good. Like, super duper good. Super good. But yeah, I love this stuff. Like, I don't have nothing bad at all to say about this makeup. Like I said, I did not order their setting powder, but they do have a powder. So what I'm gonna do is just take my this is the Laura Mercier powder that I'm gonna use to set my face. Which I mostly always use this to set my makeup anyway. No matter what kind of makeup I wear, this is like my holy grail product. Y'all, my baby is so loud. Can y'all hear? Put it in the comments if y'all can hear her being loud. She's so loud, yeah. As y'all know, Laura Mercier is a tad pricey, but definitely worth it. That's my face. She really not. Let's see. I'm super, super good on my skin. Looks good. It's a perfect match. So yeah, I'm an L30. I'm trying to think. I guess that's really all I need to show y'all. I line my lips and put a little lipstick on. Yeah, y'all. So this is the finished look. Like, all that I'm gonna do for this is just like a simple everyday look. If you don't want to wear lashes, you can wear some mascara so I can see my face matches my neck. And this is just a simple look with some makeup, a primer, a little under eye concealer, and a setting powder. You can get whatever kind of setting powder you want if you don't want to order it from Minted. But I would definitely say order from them. Like, it's worth it. It's good for your skin. And it's so pretty. I love it. Definitely love this makeup. Like I said, I would definitely be buying more from the company. If it's other types of foundations y'all know that are like, give a dewy finish, that are good, that's good for like dry skin, or that I should, or that y'all want me to try, definitely let me know and leave it below in the comments. If you already tried Minted or plan to try Minted, definitely let me know that too in the comments. Yeah, I'll leave the link below to their webpage and to, like I said, the shade that I have. But definitely go ahead on there and take the match quiz, because it is definitely accurate and it'll give you the correct shade you need. Like I said, for my dark skin beauties, this is definitely for you. This is your line, because they got so many more options for you guys than for us. And I was looking at it, I would feel kind of bad. I'm like, dang, we only get 3 colors? But because I was worried that one of them wasn't gonna fit, but it definitely does. And like I said, it looks dark when I opened it a little bit, but it was good. I definitely like it. I'm definitely gonna continue using it. Even if they would have gave me the option to return this and get my money back, I would not have returned this because it's bomb. But yeah, normally I'm like a tan or a warm honey or warm, but it's definitely a light color and that's cool. I'm okay with that. But yeah, thank y'all for watching my video. Definitely subscribe, like, comment, share, all that. If you're not already following me on Instagram, go ahead and follow me at Jalissa Mariah, and I'll post that somewhere over here on the screen. And yeah, thank y'all for watching. I'll see you in my next video, and definitely follow me on Instagram because I'm gonna be doing a giveaway soon when I hit my goal of subscribers, my next goal of subscribers. So definitely follow me on Instagram so you'll know when the giveaway is and how to enter and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, thank y'all for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Peace.